2 months ago, I jumped into a crypto project called Olympus DAO. At the time, I had never heard of Olympus DAO, so when I saw that they were paying out 8,000% annual interest, I thought that was absolutely insane and too good to be true. But after doing a lot of digging and a lot of researching, I actually came to the conclusion that the project wasn't too good to be true and that it actually seemed to work. So I decided to take a risk. I invested $5,000 and then just waited to see what would happen. And just 9 days later, with an initial investment of just $5,000, I ended up making $1,900, which I thought was crazy. And I got excited. I decided to double down and I added an additional $12,000 onto Olympus DAO, bringing my total initial investment up to $17,000. And over the next 1 week and 3 days, I made $3,362, even though the price of Olympus had actually dropped a little bit from when I had initially got in. And since then, it's been about a month and a half that I've had all this money sitting in Olympus DAO, accruing interest. And today I'm gonna talk about how much I was able to make over that month and a half being on Olympus DAO, what's next for the future of the Olympus DAO platform, and why I've decided to keep my funds staked on Olympus versus moving them to some of the other copycat projects out there in the space. First off, for those of you who don't know, Olympus DAO is the original DAO project. They're the ones who came up with this entire model for how to build a DAO where you have a treasury and they sell bonds and they buy back their own liquidity. All of that concept came from this original Olympus DAO team. And all these other projects, which some of them are really, really awesome, are essentially just copies of Olympus DAO. They didn't originally come up with this model on their own. They are trying to, some of them, put their own twist on it, but they weren't the genius minds behind the DAO model. All that credit goes to Olympus DAO. And as you can see, that team was able to create something pretty dang revolutionary in the DeFi space, where now we have, you know, hundreds of other, you know, DAO projects out there that are all trying to copy them, all trying to recapture that magic that Olympus DAO created. And although all these other projects can copy the source code of Olympus DAO, what they can't copy and they can't replicate is that amazing revolutionary genius team that came up with Olympus DAO in the first place. And over these past 2 months, that same team that originally came up with the entire DAO model has been really, really active, working to expand and further the mission of Olympus DAO. And one of the things that they've been really working on lately is something that they call Olympus Pro, which is basically bonds as a service. The DeFi model we currently use has some pretty major drawbacks, and they all really revolve around liquidity. Let's say you had a protocol and they had a token that they wanted available on Uniswap, or they wanted available on SushiSwap or PancakeSwap. Well, they rely on third parties to provide that liquidity. You and I could go, we could get some of this token and we could provide liquidity on PancakeSwap so that other people can actually buy this token. The problem is there's a lot of misaligned goals between these two parties. The protocol wants their token to go up in value. They want it to be stable. They want the liquidity to be stable. The yield farmer just wants to get paid a lot of interest and wants the project to remain relatively stable. They actually don't want it to go up or down in value. They would be glad if the project never changed in price. And what'll happen is a lot of these yield farmers might jump from project to project trying to get the highest yield. So the protocols to attract the best liquidity will provide incentives to the yield farmers to boost the amount of interest that they're getting paid. But when something bad happens, say there's a slight sell-off of the token, which causes impermanent loss for these liquidity miners, they'll freak out and they'll be like, oh, I don't wanna be in this dumb project that's having all this, you know, volatility, and they'll go and they'll sell off their liquidity. Well, with less liquidity, that causes the price to drop even faster. Users all rush for the door, everyone starts freaking out, and then more yield farmers start pulling liquidity, and it has this cascading effect where you can see, you know, a really normal, great project just absolutely plummet in price overnight. And Olympus Pro is basically a tool that will allow these different protocols to buy up their own liquidity and own their own liquidity like Olympus does. This is hugely beneficial for the protocol that implements it. It's also really beneficial for these users because they're not gonna have to worry about liquidity drying up. And it also unlocks new ways for these protocols to make money and turn a profit. And the benefit to Olympus and Olympus holders is that Olympus's treasury gets paid a fee from all of these different transactions. As all these other protocols are bonding and buying up their liquidity, Olympus is constantly getting paid in that protocol's native tokens. So the Olympus treasury is constantly getting stacked with all these other projects' tokens, further increasing the value of the treasury. And Olympus also has plans for these protocols to start buying up Ohm and using it as an asset in their own treasuries. And so far, Olympus has already signed up over 20 different protocols in a little over a month, with more signing up every single day. Olympus is also in the process of rolling out their big version 2 upgrade, which includes a lot of small incremental changes that further expands the ecosystem, improves governance, and improves security. They've added something called Ollie's apps, which allows you to buy and stake with one gas fee, which makes it a lot easier to get into Olympus and reduces the amount of gas fees you're having to pay, you know, when jumping into the project. And they've also added just a ton of new treasury assets to Bond, including Frax, Ethereum, and more. And the biggest new update is that they've started the process of going multi-chain through the Proteus initiative. They're currently in the process of launching liquidity pools on Avalanche, Phantom, Arbitrum, Optimism, Polygon, Harmony, Moonriver, Binance Smart Chain, Solana, and Terra. This is their first step in a much larger plan to take Olympus cross-chain and to continue their expansion of Ohm as a reserve currency. And the more and more I've learned about Olympus, the more and more I've become impressed by this team and by this project and the vision they're trying to create. And obviously, originally when I first got into Olympus, I was super sketched out and I was super nervous about the project because at the time, 7,000% was crazy. I get now there's like other projects that are like, oh, we're paying, you know, 80,000%, we're paying 150,000%, we're paying 5 billion percent. And by the way, just so you guys know, those crazy high percentages, when you're looking at 5 million percent, you're looking 5 billion percent. Those are not sustainable long term. The only reason these DAO projects are doing that is purely for marketing, so that they can stand apart, so people will be like, oh, look at this one, it's paying 5 million percent. We're gonna all jump into that one. And all these people jump into it, but they're gonna have to at one point either drastically lower the amount they're paying, or they're sacrificing the overall health and stability of that protocol for short-term gains. And that can be really, really dangerous if you're jumping in there, you don't really understand, you know, how these things work. You're like, oh, I'm making 5 million percent, and then the entire thing crashes around you after you do that. So just note, with a lot of these protocols, it's mainly a marketing ploy, and just to be really careful. Anyways, my original goal with Olympus was just to wait till my original investment doubled in value and then take my risk off the table. And on November 22nd, that is exactly what I did. I had my original investment essentially double in value. I really wanted to jump into this other project, so I said, hey, this is a perfect time to take my risk off the table with Olympus. My original $17,000 investment had grown to, at that point, $31,242. So what I ended up doing is I sold 17 of my Ohm, which was half of the amount of Ohm I had staked. I took that money and I used it to invest in another project, and I left the other 17 staked on Olympus DAO. And for those of you guys who were super skeptical in the comments of my last video, saying that I wasn't gonna be able to unstake and it was a trap and my funds were gonna be stuck in there forever, I was completely able to unstake, no issues whatsoever. I just clicked unstake, I paid the gas fee, and my funds were out. It was really a simple and easy process. So yeah, I hope, I don't know, for everyone that was doubtful about that, there you go. And when I sold off that Ohm, it was valued at $15,621. I hadn't quite doubled my investment. It was like, it was close enough where I was like, well, I pretty much doubled it. And as mentioned, I left the other 17 Ohm staked on the platform to just let it, you know, do its thing and see what happens. And it was doing pretty good at first, but then we had that big market crash where the price of Bitcoin plummeted, the price of everything plummeted. My entire portfolio was just looking horrible from, you know, what it had looked 2 weeks earlier. And when all that happened, the price of Olympus also dipped. And in those 2 weeks, my $15,621 has since dropped down to $11,137, which for me obviously isn't something that personally bothers me. I've at this point taken most of my risk off the table. I'm not like super concerned like that it's gonna go to zero or like the price is gonna further drop a ton from here. And even if it did further drop a ton from here, you know, Olympus-like projects don't really bother me in the same way that maybe a normal investment would bother me, because I know at least that it's accruing interest when the price is down. And since I'm not planning on selling it, well, then it doesn't really matter for me, because I know in the future, at least I'm expecting in the future, for the price to go back up. And when it does, I'll have made all that additional interest while the price was down. As more and more people unstake, that causes the interest rate, or it should cause the interest rate, to go up even further. So I'll get to accrue those rewards while the price is down, and then I'll get to reap the benefits when the price eventually goes back up. Also, for everyone who's kind of new to crypto and this is the first time you've really experienced something like this, you should know that this is a pretty much a normal thing in the crypto space. There are semi-regular massive dips like this where you'll see your portfolio just drop, just plummet overnight, and you'll lose 30%, you'll lose 40%. Sometimes you'll lose 60%, and it feels crazy. It feels like this horrible, gut-wrenching thing the first time you experience it. But in most cases, the market almost always ends up rebounding back, and it's never really that big of an issue. Now, I've been mentioning a lot lately how ridiculous it's been getting with all these Olympus DAO forks. There are so many different forks popping up every day, and it's getting more and more dangerous jumping into these forks. I told the story in my last video of how me and my brother were going to jump on this project. It was called Minos DAO, and we were gonna get into this project. It looked like a really rad project. It had a really great website. It did not at all have any sort of feeling like it was a scam. I had set aside $8,000 to throw into this project. And then when we went to try to buy, the buttons weren't working. And really quickly after, the Twitter page went down, the Discord went down, and that project ended up getting rugged. And unfortunately, that's becoming sort of a normal thing with a lot of these DAO projects. They're popping up overnight, they're rushed, they haven't been audited. And so either, you know, they're an outright scam and they're trying to take your money, or on the other hand, there's some error in the code, which I think that's what happened with Minos DAO, where they had an issue with the code that caused them to lose the funds. And so they just, you know, closed up the project and pretended like it didn't happen. And obviously there are some good forks out there. I really like Time and I like what they're doing. I like Rome and what they're doing. And I've seen a lot of other great projects that seem to be doing a good job. But you need to be extra cautious before just jumping into some of these new DAO projects. Don't just look at, you know, the interest rate. Read through all the documentation, do your research, and make sure you know what you're getting into before you do it. Now, currently, I'm not tempted at all to pull my money out of Olympus for a lot of these other forks. And I have some really good reasoning behind that. And it really comes down to the fact that these forks might be able to copy Olympus's code, but they can't copy the community and the team that have made this such a successful project. And the reality is that most of these clone projects aren't improving in any way. They're just doing an exact replica of what Olympus is doing. They're always one step behind. And I think a lot of these projects are gonna end up collapsing and consolidating into the better projects in the space. So really, it's a game of figuring out which projects are actually innovating, which projects are actually, you know, doing something unique, and focusing on those projects, not just trying to, you know, spread your money around where the APY is the highest. And I definitely think other projects besides just Olympus are gonna end up surviving. I think some of these other projects are gonna create something really unique. Some of these projects are actually linking themselves with Olympus, where like Rome, where they're actually backing their treasury with Ohm. I'm excited to see what Olympus does in the future. I feel like Olympus still has a ton of room to grow from here. They're still making a ton of smart moves. And as long as they keep doing that, I'm gonna keep my money staked and just see what happens and ride it out. And as always, none of this is investment advice. None of this is me trying to convince you to buy Ohm. This is just me chronicling my journey, sharing my journey, and talking about things that I'm passionate about or maybe I'm excited about. And on that same note, I've had a lot of people recently ask me if I was paid to talk about a certain video or if a certain video is sponsored. Just so you guys know, I don't do any sponsored videos. I've never done a sponsored video on my channel ever. I've never been paid for any of the videos I do. I've never gotten any sort of incentive or bonus or any sort of extra thing you could think of to talk about a video. In fact, I get offered those things all the time. I get Instagram messages and I get emails from these companies, and I've said no to every single one. And the reason I'm doing that is because I really want everyone to know that if I'm talking about something, I'm talking about it because I'm interested in it. I thought it was a good play to help me get to my $1 million journey, and I thought it was a good idea and it was something that I was genuinely excited about. And maybe one day I will do sponsored content and I'll do a sponsored video. And if I ever do, I'll make that super clear, and there is no way you will not know that that's a sponsored video, because I'll be really upfront and transparent and clear about it. If this video is helpful, make sure you hit that like button. If you have any comments or questions, let me know in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it if you want to actually be notified when I release new videos. If you don't hit the little bell, you won't actually be notified when I release new videos, but instead you'll have to go to the subscriptions tab, find my channel, and actually click on my channel each time you want to find out if I made a new video. Clicking the bell though allows you to actually get notifications and be alerted when I actually drop a new video. So if that's something that interests you, make sure you hit that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.